this is your public speed camera because we are now in engine control room. Engine control room is the equivalent of the bridge of wheelhouse, and it is the heart.
Heart of
the ship. Engine room or engine control room is the heart of the ship. So now we are with the chief engineer.
I am Ivan.
And the second engineer.
Hello everyone.
They will show us the different location and different equipments and machineries here in the engine room. So you will know. He will explain.
Captain's Media Chronicles. Captain's Media Chronicles, the best channel for me and to all the Filipino seamen and their family. Captain's Media Chronicles.
Like, share, and comment.
Captain's Media Chronicles.
Let's entertain. Okay, so ready?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's go.
Okay, what is happening? So this is the control console. This is the alarm panel. You have all the alarms. If you have a lot of machineries out there in the engine room, so if there's any problem in the machinery, so then there will be alarm, it should be raised and it will be displayed over here.
Mm-hmm. So and this is
alarm panel basically.
Automatic.
Automatic. And these are the two computers. This is for controlling the operation of main engine. These, number one and number two. If one fails, the other take over, so this will stay.
Mm-hmm. So there are two.
Then we have label indications for boiler control panel, and we have main engine running parameters, fuel pressure, temperature, everything is shown on this panel.
Mm-hmm.
And then
this one,
this is as we have a key for starting the engine.
Yeah.
Here you have the key, you have this telegraph. So, you move the telegraph and you can start the engine.
Uh-huh.
And for taking if your engine is running or not, you have this computer up here. You can show this one.
Okay.
So, this computer shows how much is the RPM and how much is the starting impression.
Uh-huh. So, totally electronic.
Total electronic. And okay, this is enough for this. Now we have these bus bars. This is for controlling the generators.
Mm-hmm.
Generators are meant for generating electricity on the ship. And we have three generators, number one, number two, and number three. So, for starting and for keeping them on load, we have these two, one, two, and three.
Those are for generator.
Yeah, that is for generators. And there are many pumps in the engine room. So, the starting panel for all the pumps we have here.
Mm-hmm.
We have over here. We have packing water pump, circulating pump, supply pump, LD pump. All these pumps are meant for safe operation of the main engine and other ancillary equipment in the engine room. Okay. We have one set, and if this fails, you have another set over there.
There is also for the
standard.
Uh-huh. So always there is a backup.
Always a backup. And also we have two set of electricity that are supplied on board. One is 440 volts and one is 220 volts.
Mm-hmm.
These pumps, they run on 440, but for supplying electricity on the bridge, accommodation, and forward, you have 220 volt system.
Yeah.
So for 220 volt, you have this
one. So this small one only.
220 volts.
Okay.
And 440 volts. This is 440 volt feeder panel.
Okay.
And these are the standard pumps. One set.
Okay.
Okay. So this is what we have in control room. All these items are being cooled by the AC which we have there. That is meant for cooling all the equipment out there and also for giving good temperature for us.
So this is independent, only for ECR?
Yeah, it's only for ECR.
Okay.
So now we go to engine room and take it out.
Okay.
Alright.
Chalo.
Now we have three generators out here. Number three, number two, number one.
you the starting panel of the generator. Locker. All the Marpol related hoses are kept inside the locker, and we are maintaining a Marpol lock sheet for all the hoses. Now we are going to enter the engine workshop and the engine spare part room. This is our engine workshop, and this is the lathe machine.
So this is the?
This is the lathe machine.
Okay.
This is used for fabricating tools or for, you know, cutting of a bar.
Woods or steel.
Yeah, exactly. Our company work on steel is done on the lathe machine.
Okay.
Then we have this welding machine out here.
Like whatever we do on the shore for welding, this is meant for getting any steel items.
And that is for portables?
No, this is not portable.
No, for how many bolts?
This is for portable.
For portables.
And it is locked down. This is converted to portability for
thinking.
This is the plasma cutter.
Plasma cutter. Yeah. Oh, we have also plasma.
Yes, yeah. In case you don't want to use a grinder for cutting out the face, you can use this.
Okay.
And then we have this main engine fuel valves. In your car you have fuel valves, same like the main engine on the vessel.
Fuel valves.
Yeah. So this is meant for testing. This is a fuel valve. And this is machine is meant for testing this machine.
So this is for?
This is for main engine.
Testing.
Testing the main engine fuel valve.
Okay, testing. Okay.
This is the air conditioner for the workshop. Getting good working conditions for the crew.
Uh-huh.
And we have this table for, we have all the tools out there for any repairs, we do it on stage.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And we take the store, we have a store over here. All the spares and go deep in this particular section of the ship.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, the spares are kept inside the trunks and inventory is maintained for this.
Okay.
This is the inventory.
So you have all the critical equipments and various spare parts.
Spare parts over here in this store.
So we are ready for any malfunction.
Yeah, if there is any malfunction in the machinery, we have spares, we change the spare and we keep the machinery running.
Oh, okay. It's audio,
audio and
visual. Okay.
This is, in case there is abandoned ship.
Okay, so there is.
Like, this is for fire alarm, this is for CO2 release, this is for rifle vest, this is for alarm, this is for headlamp. If somebody has light, you know, headlamp alarm, this is.
So there is an individual.
It's a light column.
So it's individual, okay.
And then for the phone which you call on the bridge, this is the phone.
It will give an alarm also. Okay.
We have EVD on all the platforms. So this is EVD for the workshop.
Uh-huh.
And this is emergency escape breathing device. It works for 15 minutes. This is only used for escaping purpose.
Uh-huh. Okay.
We have here grinding and pumping machine. If you want to drill a hole somewhere, if you want to drill a hole, we have this machine.
Okay.
In any plate, anywhere.
So, it's heavy duty, huh?
It's heavy duty. Yes, this is fixed. This is heavy duty.
Okay.
So, these are the lube oil tanks for the engine room, the lube oil tanks for generators, for the main engine, and the cylinder oil. Switches for these tanks. If ever the oil level comes down, this will give an alarm in the ECR. This is the daily cylinder oil tank for the main engine. We transfer this oil from this tank to this tank. RCS valve remote control system for the hydraulic valves on deck which are being operated hydraulically, and we have two pumps, one stand back. These are the critical spares for the main engine. Here you can see the cylinder timer. These are the studs. This is the hydraulic pipe. These are all critical spares for the main engine. This is the piston for the main engine spare. One cylinder head along with this exhaust valve.
So cylinder head, piston,
liner, exhaust valve and cylinder.
Exhaust valve.
Liner. Then we have two more spares, exhaust valve for the main engine.
Uh-huh, so total three.
Total three. So we keep them overhauled and ready for use.
Uh-huh.
This is the air conditioning plant panel.
we have on board. This is the reefer machinery plant for the cold chambers on board, meat room, fish room and veg room. We have the gas oil tanks, which are for the engine room, for main engine, auxiliary engine and the boiler, auxiliary boiler and composite boiler. And this is the panel for the Marflex cargo system. We have an electronic cargo pumping system on board. So this is the electronic panel of the Marflex cargo system.
Individual panel for its cargo pump.
Yes, sir. So from this is the local panel. We can start and stop the cargo pumps from here if we take it on local. But we do it on remote. We have a remote cargo monitoring system in the CCR. These are quick closing walls. If in case of fire, if you isolate, you want to isolate the generator, the fuel system to operate is the electric stop. This is used only in case of fire otherwise. Okay, this is the main engine and we can see exhaust valves, cylinder head and the liners. These are the six exhaust valves, the cylinder heads, the liners, and we have the turbocharger.
So this is the turbocharger.
Turbocharger for the main engine. Like you have a small turbocharger in your car, for this big engine, your big turbocharger.
So it's taking up the exhaust.
Yeah, it takes the exhaust from the exhaust. The exhaust comes from here and drives the turbocharger. Turbocharger compresses here and gets
to the engine room.
Hydraulic pumps meant for giving hydraulic power to the main engine so that we can start, stop and run the main engine. Number one. This is the last water treatment system. This is used for treating the seawater which we take to the ship. Before taking, we do electrolysis and brine electrolysis with the living acids. That is preventing microorganisms to generate in the water and then we give it to the ballast tanks. This is freshwater generator. We generate fresh water from sea water. This is a plant for generating fresh water for consumption, for drinking also and to recover also.
Here you can see we are generating 0 ppm fresh water from this fresh water generator.
Hello, sir.
This is the jacket water heater. In this, we are water for the main engine. This is the freshwater central cooling system. We have two central coolers, number one and number two. We are having fresh water cooled system on board, so this is a closed system. We have two fresh water cooling systems on board, which are cooled by seawater, that is an open loop system, and fresh water being cooled in the closed loop system.
So normal temperature.
Yes.
We
have this control valve. Temperature is reached, the cooler will shut off and it will go in bypass. If the temperature is more, the cooler will open. Over here. Same. So these are the three LT pumps. Because this ship we have fresh water cooling system, so we have three fresh water cooling pumps. So this is three pumps, always two pumps are running, one is on standby. Jacket water, high temperature, fresh water pumps for main engine. We have one spare, one is always running. Made for pulling the jacket of the main engine, the lighters. Made for pulling.
That's seawater, huh?
Fresh water.
Fresh water.
This is the sewage treatment plant. All human waste comes here from all the cabins, all the urinals, and it is processed here and then discharged. This is the vacuum tank sewage treatment plant, and it is fully fresh water. There is no seawater system out here. We have complete fresh water connected with this, and we have two vacuum pumps. Dosing sodium hypochlorite. This is the sterilization chamber before the sewage is pumped overboard. So we are maintaining the pH value. This is the sewage discharge overboard. This is the sewage from the toilets which is coming to this plant. First two chambers, hot chamber, activated carbon chamber, sterilization chamber. After dosing of the sterilization chamber, this pump is pumping the sewage overboard.
So it's four stages, huh?
Yeah. We have two tanks, the septic tank, then we have this sedimentation tank, and then we have the activated carbon tank, then your sterilization chamber.
And finally, where is the discharge? So this is the last stage.
Yeah, this is the last stage. And this is the compressor. This is the compressor to give fresh air to the sewage plant so that we have bacteria inside which can eat the human waste.
Okay.
This is main engine lubricating oil filter. The oil which is circulating in the main engine is to filter. This is for that. One is automatic, one is manual.
This is filter.
Filter.
Automatic and manual. Okay, filter.
main engine and generators.
Oh, so for
generators. Just like for car you use heat, here you use air for starting.
Okay.
This is control air dryer. This is used for drying the air from the bottles and giving to the main engine.
Okay.
Water you collect, oily water you collect in the engine room, that we put in bilge tank, and from bilge tank we pump it overboard by filtering it through this equipment.
Also pylorus.
All the oily water which passes through and goes overboard. Most important equipment. This is hot well. This is like a feed tank for the boilers. We have two boilers, composite boiler and auxiliary boiler. So, for giving water to the boilers, the water is stored here. And then for two pumps at the bottom, which are used for pumping water in the boiler.
This is not yet still ambient temperature.
Yeah, this is not high temperature, normal 70 degrees.
Yes, ambient.
Yeah. ICCP, Impressed Current Cathodic Protection. So the whole ship is made of metal and the seawater causes corrosion to the metal. To prevent that, we have this cathodic protection. This prevents the hull of the vessel from getting rusted and decomposed.
Okay. So even the hull are electronic controlled, huh?
Yeah, electronic. This is the purifier room.
First before going to the engine.
Yes, yes. The generator that for main engine to be purified and given to the engine. The purifiers. Also we have the pumps for giving feed to the boilers, and also we have cooler out here. If the main engine is on gas oil, we use this cooler for cooling the gas oil. These are the four fuel oil settling and service tanks. We have two settling and two service tanks. So one set is always in use and another is on standby.
Yeah.
turbocharger is cooled from here. This is the air cooler.
How much is the temperature?
For normal engine running, it can vary from 35 to 45 degrees.
So it's not so much, hot?
No. When it is going to that cooler, it is
going to the air cooler, it is around 140, 150, and it is cooling until 30 to 40 degrees.
So it reduced the temperature.
You can see the oil coming out of the turbocharger. This is the lubricating oil for turbocharger. These are the two auxiliary blowers. When you want to start engine, the turbocharger is not running. For starting engine, we use these two blowers with white air for starting.
It's electric, huh?
It's electric.
Here you can see we have two fire pumps, two sets of ballast pump. Then we have the ejector pump for the freshwater generator. Then we have three main seawater pumps for the engine room. All of these are pumps. Yes, all these are pumps, seawater pumps.
Seawater pumps.
We have two sea chests, one on the port side, this is the high sea chest, one on the starboard side, that is the low sea chest. These are the sea suction, main sea suction for all these pumps.
Automatic also?
Yes, automatic. And as we showed in the workshop, this is one more EBD we have here. This is also same for 15 minutes only for escaping purpose. This is the flywheel of the main engine.
firefighting extinguisher. In case of any fire, we can use it to fight the fire.
Another we have here 9-liter portable foam extinguisher for firefighting in Indian Road.
This one?
Bilge pump. This pump is used for transferring bilge water from the bilge wells to the bilge holding tank. And this is the sludge pump used for transferring sludge the waste oil tank, and where we from the waste oil tank we burn the sludge in the waste oil incinerator.
Okay, these are the four pumps, feed water pumps for the boiler. The smaller pumps are for the composite boiler, the big is for the auxiliary boiler. This is for boiler feed pumps.
Water.
Yeah. This gets access from the hot well, which we shown upwards, and give to the boiler for steam generation. This is our electrical officer, Babi sir. So he is overhauling one of the motors, the new part was so far. He is overhauling the motor. Level indicator for the tank, the oil bilge tank level indicator. How much we can see here over here, how much quantity is there. It will show the depth and the quantity we can see.
Okay. Here we have fuel oil and diesel oil transfer pumps for transferring oil from bunker tanks to our service tanks and settling tanks.
Okay. Well, MGO and
yes,
separator.
This is fuel oil.
Okay. This is better, not like old system, pusher.
Okay, this is better.
Yeah, it's a fix.
This is and our only way, Jared.
We have a rudder angle indicator here. This is a repeater from the bridge. Also, we can see it from here also. The local panel. From that side, you can see. This steering gear room also serves as a chemical locker and a lube oil locker. This is the chemical locker. All these chemicals are distributed in three categories: alkaline, acidic, and neutral. We have alkaline chemicals, acidic chemicals, neutral chemicals, which are used on board for treatment purposes, cleaning purposes. And we have two freshwater domestic tanks in the steering gear room. This is the port side tank, and one is on the starboard side. This is the level gauge for the port side tank.
This is the hypermist system, because this ship is UMIS. UMIS as in unmanned machinery space. Out at sea, the engine room is unmanned. There is no one inside the engine room. All machinery is running automatically. If there is a fire, with smoke and flame, then this will be automatically activated, and selected areas like main engine, boiler, generators, they will be sprayed with fresh water, so that by the time the engineers come down and see what the situation is, the fire is taken under control. This works automatically only on the activation of smoke and flame sensor. And this is the emergency fire pump. It's in case of fire on the ship or in the deck or engine room, this pump is used for firefighting.
This emergency fire pump can be started from the bridge, from the fire station, from the engine control room.
This is train station, huh?
Here we have two sets of fireman outfit in the steering gear room. So we have one set in the midship and one set in the home station, fire station, and accordingly, whenever there is a fire on board, we can select from where to take the fire equipment and fight the fire.
These are the oxygen cylinders. These are oxygen cylinders, and we have the firefighting suit inside this bag.
We have the firefighting gear inside this bag,
the helmet, the shoes, and the gun to fight the fire.
This drill for firefighting is being carried out weekly on board our ship. This is a fire hose. Again, we can connect it to a fire hydrant and fight the fire with the fire hydrant.
boiler, and this is also in the ECR. We can run this boiler from the ECR also.
So this is also not running.
Yeah, because we are using auxiliary boiler, we are doing some maintenance, so this boiler is stopped right now.
Okay.
Okay, so now the chief engineer and the second engineer has toured us in various location, various equipments in the engine room, also the engine control room, as well as the different piping system. So the chief engineer to talk with you somewhere to tell you something.
Alright, so we are having very good time on board with a good captain and a good crew members what we have. We have a beautiful engine room and deck. We are working hard so that there are no delays. And the most important thing is that we work very safely so that there are no delays and there is no problem to anyone. So the only thing about thing is that is come safely and go home safely. That is what our motto is. So that our family and we can have good time.
Come home, rest, not as a luggage, not as a luggage. Okay, second.
Hello everyone. Well, as you have seen, the chief engineers explained everything and shown all the equipments and machinery in the engine room. And everything is working fine. And well, that's it. That's all we have in the engine room. We have a captain here.
Keep liking and supporting Captain's channel.
Yeah, please like and vote for this channel. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Jeff.
Come on, subscribe now. Don't you ever hesitate. It's a Seaman YouTube channel. Everybody can relate. Captain's Media Chronicles, the best channel for me and to all the Filipino Seaman and their family. Captain's Media Chronicles. Like, share, and comment. Captain's Media Chronicles.